Welcome back to the channel MySEMHelp.in. In this video, we will look into the how MRP Live has evolved from classic MRP, what are all the differences, and also what are all the new functionalities that have come in the MRP Live. So this is a quick comparison between classic MRP and MRP Live, which will give you a snapshot about what are all the differences and what are all the new functionalities. We will see it in the SAP as a live thing, but before that, to have a quick input, we are looking into this. So in the planning scope area, in the classic MRP MD01, you had something called scope of planning. In scope of planning you use, but in MD01N, which is MRP live, you don't have the field called scope of planning. Okay. Here in the plant, we will be able to give only single plant in the classic MRP. But in MRP Live, you can give multiple plans. The same thing applies for product group MRP controller. And also new field called material scope is also introduced, where you can say all MPS materials are MRF materials like that. In control parameters, if you see the classic MRP had lot of keys. I think to make it very lean and to improve the performance, etc., there have been many fields which has been suppressed, which means the subsequent functionalities has also been removed during the process of MRP. Like there is no processing key, there is no purchase requisition, create purchase requisition field, or generate schedule lines, MRP list generation, etc. In planning mode also, you are having 1 and 3 only, and scheduling we have. And for process control parameters, where MRP, classic MRP had something called parallel processing, where if your MRP is taking much times, then you can give some application servers, split them, and then you can run them through parallel processings, which was one of the functionality to increase the the performance in classic MRP. But by default, the objective of MRP Live was to improve the performance. That has been removed, and displaying material list is also has also been removed. And in the we used to have a user exit to control, like if you want to run for set of MRP controllers or product groups, restrict, include, exclude, that has been removed in the MRP Live. And we didn't have a customer extension, but right now you have a customer extension in MRP Live, where if you wanted to do some inclusion exclusions, that kind of thing can be done through the customer exclusions. So for a quicker information, I am comparing the MD01, which is listed in the left side. So you can see the left side is having our classic MRP, which is MD01. And in the right side, we have the MRP Live, which is MD01N, which is from the S/4HANA part. You can see in the planning part, what we said initially, we said the scope of planning and plant is included in the MRP run, that's in the classic MRP, but the scope of planning has been removed from the MRP Live. And you can see some of the additional planning scope elements here, like we have plant, material, product group, MRP controller, material scope. So this is what the planning scope, what we were talking, like where it has material, product group, MRP controller, and material scope. So if you see in the material scope, we have different parameters. So inside the material scope, we will have different parameters where we can say run the MRP for all materials, or run for only for the MRP materials only, or for MPS materials only. So this is the use of the material scope here. And this should not be confused with scope of planning, what we had in the classic MRP. The next one, what we will see, is about the MRP control parameters. For the MRP control parameters, we can see we are having many parameters, right? Like processing key, purchase equation, schedule lines. But when you come to MRP Live, you will not see most of the things, okay? Only the planning mode is there and scheduling is there. Other than that, nothing is available here. So we can see here, this is where we are having our scheduling and planning mode. which is which was there in the ECC. Now it's here in the scheduling and the planning mode. So the other thing is we were using the user exit key for to selecting some MRP based on some MRP type or MRP controller, etc. Now we are having some customer extensions. These customer extension, there is an SAP note. Based on that SAP note only you will be able to implement this customer extension. Generally in normal S4 HANA, when you do this MRP live, this customer extension is not immediately available. But once you activate that, then you will have this MRP type, MRP group, low level code, etc. So that will help you to do some more filters, etc. here. So another one important thing in the MRP live is, if you see here, we have something called stock transfer materials, which when you wanted to plan for, when you wanted to plan for the stock transfer orders, which is in the other plant also, then if you activate this, so the MRP can be run, will be run for the other plant also. So this functionality was not there in the classic MRP. And also in earlier you had NETCH, net change for total horizon, then regenerative planning, and in the planning period. But in S4 HANA you have only regenerative planning, which can be activated whenever you want. Otherwise it will be always an NETCH only. So by and large, this covers some of the key functionalities which have been enhanced in the ECC, sorry, in the S4 HANA on the name of MRP Live. And maybe we will do one more detailed video only for MRP Live with some live examples, how the planning, etc. is being done, and how the MRP evaluation is done, and what are the results evaluation, etc. Okay. If you have any questions or queries, please leave it in the comment. We will reply you back onto that. Okay. Thanks for watching this.